ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितप्रज्ञानः प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूषितं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं विन्दुं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने श्रीमूर्तये नमः सहना भवतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूचनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूचतस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रयजनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् I'm creating a blank page. Let me reopen the app. Is that strange? Is the screen visible? It was showing some blank. I think it's not blank now, right?
No.
Okay. So, Shri Guru Bhyo Namah. Okay. So, we were looking at the Tika. निर्गुणत्वं धर्मराहित्यम् इति मत्वा शङ्कते ननु इति. सो नौ वाट् हेज़् बीन् सेड् इस् दट् धर्मी अध्यास इस् नाट् पासिबल्, धर्म अध्यास इस् नाट् पासिबल् बिट्वीन् आत्मा एण्ड् अनात्मा. नौ दि इश्यू इस् हौ केन् दि निर्गुणब्रह्म हेव् धर्म और् गुण. धर्म मीन्स् गुण. सो हौ केन् निर्गुणब्रह्म हेव् गुण which you are denying to be adhyastha in anatma. This discussion itself is invalidated because you yourself claim that Brahma is nirguna. So it is not prapta even. There is no guna to be superimposed. Why would you even talk about that? Therefore, nanu, in Ratna Prabha, nanu atmanaha nirgunatve तद्धर्माणमिति भाष्यं कथमिति चेदुच्यते. हौ कैन यू हैव अ वर्ड सच एज तद्धर्माणाम आत्मधर्माणाम. दैट काइंड ऑफ अ फ्रेज इट्सेल्फ इज नॉट वैलिड उच्यते बुद्धिवृत्ति अभिव्यक्तम चैतन्यम ज्ञानम विषयाभेदन अभिव्यक्तम स्फुरणम शुभकर्मजन्य वृत्तिव्यक्तम आनंदः इत्येवं वृत्त्युपाधि कृतभेदात् ज्ञानादीनाम् आत्मधर्मत्व व्यपदेशः. सो आत्मधर्मत्व व्यपदेश देर इज अ यूसेज ऑफ आत्मधर्मत्व बट इट इज नॉट मुख्य प्रयोग. इट इज दी अभिव्यक्त चैतन्य दी चैतन्य विच इज मैनिफेस्ट. इट इज दी अभिव्यक्त आनंद द आनंद विच इज मैनिफेस्ट. इवन दी वृत्ति रूप ज्ञान मैनिफेस्ट दी चैतन्य. घटा घटाकार वृत्ति मैनिफेस्ट दी चैतन्य. सिमिलरली ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति मैनिफेस्ट दी आनंद. इवन दी विषय आनंद वृत्ति मैनिफेस्ट दी आनंद विच इज दी ब्रह्मानंद. देयरफॉर दिस आत्मानंद ब्रह्मानंद और आत्मचैतन्य ब्रह्म चैतन्य और एल्सवेयर वेयर नित्यत्व अपीयर्स दैट इज ऑल मैनिफेस्ट. एंड सिंस दी आत्म स्वरूप इज मैनिफेस्ट बाय तत्तद्वृत्ति therefore the upahita chaitanya and upahita atma itself is stated as dharma. So it's not a mukhya prayoga. So buddhi vritti abhivyakta chaitanyam jnanam. What is jnana? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma or sachidananda brahma. There jnana shabda is that which is buddhi vritti abhivyaktam chaitanyam. It is that chaitanya alone which is manifest in the vritti as jnana. And then there are so many vishayas. Vishayabhedena abhivyaktam spuranam. The vishaya, vishayavachinna chaitanya. Vishayavachinna chaitanya. Thereby what happens? The vishaya, विषयगत चैतन्य एंड दी वृत्तिगत चैतन्य प्रमात्रगत चैतन्य ऑल हैव अभेद. व्हेनेवर यू हैव घटाकार वृत्ति देन दी घटा इज नथिंग बट दी मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर चैतन्य. व्हेन दी घट वृत्ति घटाकार वृत्ति टेक्स अवे दी घटाकार घट अज्ञान. सो घट विषयक Tulajnana is taken away by the Ghatakara Vritti, then the Chaitanya becomes manifest as Ghata. Ghata Jnana. Ghata Vishaya also, Ghata Jnana also. So Jnana has been talked about earlier. Now this Vishaya, the Ghata Bhana that you have, Ghata Vishaya Bhana that you have, that itself is called as Puranam. So Ghata Asti, घटमहम जानामि. सो दिस चैतन्य बिकम्स अभिन्न विद दि विषयगत चैतन्य दिस प्रमातृगत चैतन्य आल्सो एंड वृत्तिगत चैतन्य आल्सो बिकॉज वृत्ति इज इन दि अंतकरण वेयर इट्सेल्फ दि चैतन्य इज मैनिफेस्ट एज प्रमाता. सो प्रमाता प्रमेय एंड प्रमा ऑल दीज थ्री इन दि त्रिपुटी आर नथिंग बट चैतन्य. But they get different names based on what aspect is manifest in the antakarana, what is the cognition about, what is the vritti about. Based on that, there is a name tag given. So, Shubha Karma Janya Vritti Vyaktam Anandaha Iti Evam Vritti Upadhi Krita Bheda. These are Vritti Upadhi Krita Bheda. There is no real Bheda. Based on the vritti, which is an upadhi, and these vrittis are various. Based on that, there is a vritti kuta as though bheda. It's not real bheda. And the ananda term is used when there is a shubha karma janya vritti. Shubha karma, somebody has done lot of punya earlier. then at that, in fact, there is a mix of punya and papa. But what happens is ananda is manifest only when the punya is ready to fructify. That time you come across a particular vishaya that you like, you have raga towards, and then you are able to consume that vishaya through whichever indriya is appropriate for that vishaya, and then the punya gets exhausted by such a ananda vritti being manifest due to the vishaya consumption, which we call as vishaya ananda, and we wrongly attribute to the vishaya. Whereas it is the same ananda, same chaitanya which is manifest, and one feels the ananda, which is atma ananda. It is not a guna of atma. Swarupa of atma gets manifest in that manner with gradations, priya moda pramoda vritti. So shubha karma janya vritti, that vritti, vrittyaha vyaktam chaitanyam. You have to bring chaitanyam here. So buddhi vritti abhivyaktam chaitanyam jnanam, vishayabhedena abhivyaktam kim chaitanyam eva spuranam, shubha karma janya vritti vyaktam kim chaitanyam eva anandaha iti evam vritti upadhi krita bhedat chaitanyasya upadhi krita bhedat vritti upadhi krita bhedat. As though bheda, the same chaitanya is called as what? Jnanam spuranam ananda. Jnanadinam atmadharmatva vipadesha. And then when this name tag is given, that itself is seen as dharma. It is not the dharma of atma, not a guna of atma. The same nirguna chaitanya atma, brahmatma, get the jnanadinam atmadharmatva vipadesha. Get the vipadesha as jnana, etc. Taruktam tikayam. And that is said in the tika in Vivarana. Anando vishyanubhava nityatvam cha iti santi dharma apratakve api chaitanyat prathag iva avbhasante iti. So prathag iva avbhasante, they appear to be separate and gunavat, dharmavat, gunavat. They are not really dharma, as though santi dharma apratakve api, although they are non-different from what? Chaitanyat apratakve api, even if they are non-different from chaitanya, these santi dharma, which are those anandaha vishyanubhavaha nityatvam. So ananda vishyanubhava nityatvam, these are all dharmas which are not different from chaitanya. They are the swarupa of chaitanya, but they appear to be different from chaitanya, although being non-different from chaitanya. Prithak iva apratakve api chaitanyat apratakve api chaitanyat prithak iva avabhasante. So iva is very important there, as though iti. Tika jnanam ityanena pratyakshanumityadikam uchyate. So what is the word jnanam there? Chaitanyam, which is manifest, is called as jnana by buddhi vritti. When there is a antakarana vritti which is buddhyakara. Buddhyakara means there is some buddhi is not a karana there. Buddhi in a sense, prama takes place. Some prama or yathartha or ayathartha need not be necessarily prama itself, but there is some knowledge which is taking place, whether for right or wrong, some knowledge is taking place in the antakarana. That akara of the knowledge itself, so buddhi there is jnana actually. This buddhi here means jnana. It is a bhave vyutpatti, bhave tin pratya. Then that buddhi vritti manifests chaitanya, which is called as jnana. Or other way, if you look at it, jnana vritti abhivyakta chaitanyam jnanam. Abhivyaktam chaitanyam or avyakta chaitanyena samasa. So jnana vritti abhivyaktam chaitanyam jnanam. It is upachariyate. It is a upachara. So jnanamityana, what is that jnana? Jnanamityana pratyakshanumityadikam uchyate. It need not be pratyaksha itself. It can be anumiti also. Any jnana which takes place, there will be a vritti in the antakkarana. So when there is a ghatakara vritti, or in the paksha of parvata, when you are looking at dhuma, so dhuma is pratyaksha, but vanni is anumita. So when anumiti jnana takes place, that time also vritti will take place in the antakarana. Oh, there has to be vanni there, since there is dhuma. So that time also the chaitanya which is manifest will be called as jnana. Then spuranam ityaneno. Why is chaitanya called as spurana? So spurana is a term which will include pratyaksha also, not anumiti particularly, because there also it can be extended, but spuranam ityaneno, there pratyaksha prama which takes place in the antakarana is called as spuranam. Subhana ghata asti. Actually ghata asti and ghata bhanam cannot really be separated, so although technically we do, that's why it looks like a repetition here. Pratyakshanam ityadikam uchyate jnanam ityanena spuranam ityanena pratyaksham. So there seems to be a shade of overlap. By complete overlap also pratyaksha, but pratyaksha vishaya pratyaksha jnana, these are different. So ghata asti and ghatamaham janami. If ghata asti, how do you know? You are not stating it from somebody else's perspective. Otherwise, the statement would be ghata asti iti kaschid vadati. We say ghata asti, and if we say ghatam aham na janami, then we have to infer that this ghata is there is a hearsay. But in the situation where you say ghata is there in front of you, that time this astitva and bhana is very difficult to separate out. So spuranam is the bhana of the ghata, and astitva of the ghata is also there, jnana of the vishaya is there, jnana of the jnana is also there. So there is a gradations, there is a hierarchy of vrittis which are possible based on how much one inquires. All that is manifestation of chaitanya. Shubha karma ityanena. What is this shubha karma? Shubha karma is that karma which led to punya. So shubha karma ityanena, shubha karma hetu kam. Shubha karma hetu yasya. So it's a bahuri, therefore you have kap pratyaya. So shubha karma hetu ka madhuryadi rasavastu bhakshanadikam uchyate. So what is this shubha karma itself? Karma is a term used for karma also and karma phala also. Punya. So punya karma also, and punya which is a resultant of that punya karma as phala. So shubha karma itself becomes a hetu. Thereby hetu for what? For bhakshana, for your rejoicing something, consuming something. Here the example given is madhuri adi. So something that you like sweets, then madhuriya, that sweetness is consumed by you. So madhuryadi rasa. Rasa, swada is being taken by you. So such vastu is needed. That rasa becomes vastu, and vastu consumption is called as bhakshanam. So bhakshanadikam, adipadena, based on whichever indriya is dealing with whichever vishaya, then both those adis can be put together with tattad vishaya, tattad indriya. So one example is given as an upalakshana, and thereby what happens, vishaya anubhava takes place, which is desirable to you. That is the important part here, to manifest ananda. If it is undesirable, then that going away can be taken away. Taken as an example, if you do not like something, and separation from that kind of an object which you don't like, that itself will give you ananda. So vishaya anubhava or vishaya going away, undesirable vishaya going away is the vishaya anubhava. The anubhava of that separation also will give you ananda. So shubha karma hetu ka madhuryadi rasavastu bhakshanadikam uchyate kena shubha karma ityanena vishaya anubhava ityanena. Then vishaya anubhava, which is mentioned there, vishaya anubhava, this is a separate part. So vishaya anubhava here, the vishaya anubhava need not be taken there, but I mentioned this vastu bhakshana is a vishaya bhakshana, or vishaya going away also, which is undesirable, that is also an anubhava which will generate a vritti which will be ananda, will be called as ananda. Chaitanya will be manifest as ananda. Vishayanuhava ityanena pratyakshanumityadikam nityatvam utpatyadi rahityam shuddhatvadehe idam upalakshanam. So many things have been said. There are no commas here. So we have to read Vishayanuhava ityanena pratyakshanumityadikam. Again, pratyaksha ityadi, all these anuhavas which are yathartha or ayathartha, all those are to be taken by Vishayanuhava. Further, nityatvam, when nityatvam is mentioned, nityatvam of atma, what kind of dharma is that? So nityatvam utpatyadi rahityam, that chaitanya does not have utpatti, therefore it is called as nitya chaitanya. Nityatvam is not a guna of atma, it just tells you that there is no utpatti of atma. Otherwise, utpatyadi rahityam is not a dharma, really. It is not a guna. Similarly, nityatvam is not a dharma or a guna. But it is also an upalakshan of what? Shuddhatvadehe. Idam upalakshanam. So, shuddha, nitya, shuddha, buddha, mukta, all these words which are used, they all should be understood in that manner as to whichever vritti manifests it. Or, in the case of nityatvam, shuddhatvam, it is... So nityatvam, when you say, it is utpatyadi rahityam. If you say shuddhatvam, then shuddhatvam is ashuddhatva rahityam. So ashuddhi rahityam can be considered as shuddhatvam. And so on. Any dharma should be seen in this manner. It is not a guna for nirgunatma. Avabhasante ityasya taduktam ityanena anvaya. So tikayam taduktam. Iva avbhasante iti taduktam tikayam. That is how the anvaya is. Antakarna vritti rupa upadhi vashat na sorry. Antakarna vritti rupa upadhi vashat nana iva avbhasante ityartha. So nana iva avbhasante. What has been said here? Chaitanya prithak iva. So prithak is nana. Prithak nana iva avabhasante chaitanya. From chaitanya they appear to be prithak, different, and many also. Nana iva. So nana can be added to it. So prithak iva has though many, but there are no many dharmas. It is only the same chaitanya which is manifest, not only as dharmas. Everything that is manifest is all. Vishaya is also, all vishayas are manifestations of the same Chaitanya. Entire Prapancha is a manifestation of the same Chaitanya by Nama and Rupa. That is the idea there. Advaita mate adhyasa samagra bhava aham spurami ityadi stale jnanadhyasaha arthadhyasachana sambhavati iti tarkikadi purvapakshe tatpariyam adhyasakshepa upasamhara vyajena avishkaroti ata iti. Now there is an objection as to Advaita. In Advaita Mata, Adhyasa Samagri isn't there. Why Adhyasa Samagri is not there? Because the very first Samagri is, there should be a Pramahita Samskara. That is not possible. We have seen that Atma Anatma were never one to leave a Samskara for this Adhyasa to take place. Either way. Atma on anatma or anatma on atma. Then sadrishya, dosha, ityadi, those are also there. But then they are secondary. When this primary pramahita samskara itself is not there, then if samskara is not there, even if you have dosha, even if there is sadrishya, there cannot be adhyasa primarily. Because the main samagri is what? There should be some samskara. Otherwise, it is not possible. This is the idea there. Advaita mate adhyasa samagriya bhavat aham spurami. Then aham spurami. Aham is ahankara. Spurami. Chaitanya dharma that you are talking about, that should be manifest, you are saying. How will it manifest with tadatme sambandha? There is a aham spurami. Spurami is a tinganta pada. Uttama purusha ek vachana. And aham is ahankara, which is a subanta. So now this aham, asmat pada प्रथमा एक वचन अहम स्फुरामि देर देर इज अ थिंग सामानाधिकरण दिस थिंग सामानाधिकरण विद द अहंकार इज नॉट पॉसिबल ऑन वन साइड द थिंग व्हाट यू आर लुकिंग एट इज आत्मा एंड अहंकार सामानाधिकरण दैट्स व्हाट इट मीन्स इत्यादि स्थले ज्ञानाध्यास दि ज्ञान इज ऑल्सो अध्यस्त एंड विषय इज ऑल्सो अर्थ विषय इज ऑल्सो अध्यस्त बोथ आर नॉट पॉसिबल न संभवती इति तार्किकादि पूर्वपक्षी तात्पर्यम् दिस इज दि आइडिया ऑफ दि पूर्वपक्षी सिंस अध्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल बोथ टाइप्स ज्ञान ऑल्सो विषय ऑल्सो देयरफॉर अध्यासाक्षेप उपसंहार व्याजेन आविष्करोति ब्रिंग्स अबाउट दि रत्न प्रभाकर ब्रिंग्स अबाउट दिस पूर्वपक्ष ऑफ दि तार्किक एंड देन कंक्लूड्स एज वेल as to the Akshepa Bhashya, the Tika, the Vyakhya on the Akshepa Bhashya, he concludes, Ataha, Ratna Prabha, Ataha, Nirguna Brahmatmatumate, Nirguna Brahma, Nirgunam Yad Brahma, Saheva Atma, Iti Mate. So the Mata is that Nirguna Brahma is Nirguna and that is Atma itself. अहं करोमि इति प्रतीतेर अर्थस्य च अध्यासत्वायोगात् प्रमात्वम् अहं नरः इति सामानाधिकरण्यस्य गौणत्वम् इति मतम् आस्थेयम् देयरफॉर निर्गुण ब्रह्म बीइंग आत्मा अहं करोमि दि कर्तृत्व इज दि अहंकारादि धर्म एंड अहं इज व्हाट अहम करोमी देर तादात्म्य संबंध इज देर विद दी अहंकार एंड देन वन एंड्स अप सेइंग आई एम दी कर्ता इति प्रतीते है सिंस दिस प्रतीति इज व्हाट दिस प्रतीति इज देर डेफिनेटली अहम करोमी दैट काइंड ऑफ प्रतीति इज देर दिस प्रतीति इज व्हाट ज्ञान अहम करोमी आई एम डूइंग समथिंग आई डू सम थिंग्स All this is what? Is a pratiti, it is jnana. Now, is this jnana prama or brahma? Since adhyasa is not possible, therefore what? It should be taken as prama. In fact, there is a Pathaveda also, which is a better Pathaveda. Here in Tika, you don't see that as considered. But if you look up the Advaita Sharada website, you will see the Ratna Prabha reading is... just give me a moment, I had made a note there. There is Satyatvam word there. I remember Satyatvam. So, Asmat Pratyaya Gochara Vishaya. Just give me one moment. Nityatvam Cheti. Ataha Nirguna Brahmatvaya. So, Ataha Nirguna Brahmatmatva Mate. Aham Karomiti Pratiter Arthasya Cha Adhyasatva Ayogat. So, till here it is same. Adhyasasya. Ayogat, then Pramatvam. After Pramatvam, there are two words. Pramatvam, Satyatvam cha. So, it can be split and read. In the Tika, what has been taken? Pramatvam itself has been taken. There is no Satyatvam cha. But there is a reading Satyatvam cha. Tikakara explains in the same manner though. He interprets the meaning as Satyatvam there. But Aham Karomiti Pratitehe Arthasya cha. Since प्रतीते अर्थस्य च अध्यासत्व योगात् अध्यासत्व अयोग इज हेतु देयरफॉर व्हाट इज नॉट पॉसिबल अहम करोमि इति प्रतीति एंड अर्थ बोथ आर नॉट प्रमा सो सॉरी बोथ आर नॉट अध्यास अहम करोमि इति प्रतीति कैन नॉट बी एन अध्यास व्हाई बिकॉज सामग्री इज इन देयर इन दी अद्वैत Brahmatma Mata, there is no Samagri. Because of Samagri Abhava, Adhyasa is not possible. So, Adhyasatva Yoga, this is a Hetu. Since it is not an Adhyasa, Aham Karomi is not an Adhyasa, then if it is not an Adhyasa, what is it? It is Prama. Therefore, Artha also that you see as Dharma in something Anatma, what is that? That is all Satya. It is also Prama, Prama Vishaya. It is not prama, but it is prameya. So pramatvam there should be interpreted a little differently. So pratitehe pramatvam, jnanasya pramatvam, vaktavyam. Why? It is not an adhyasa, it is not a brahma. If aham karomi is not a brahma, what about the artha? The artha also has to be real. It is not a brahma vishaya. So pramatvam is not there in the aham karomi pratiti, in that jnana. So that jnana adhyasa is not possible. What about the vishaya, the ahankara, dharma, etc.? And then it will extend to entire prapancha. Ghatapatadi prapancha also. All those are what? They cannot be adhyastha in chaitanya. We say that prapancha is also adhyastha in chaitanya. Ahankara, which is part of the prapancha, is adhyastha on the sakshi, whereby there is pramatta kind of a chidabhasa. Pratibimba which takes place, and one claims that antakarana to be one's own, and then dharma also as one's own, and therefore there is a dharmi adhyasa and a dharma adhyasa. This is the idea which was questioned. Similarly, outside in the prapancha, all of the vishayas are adhyasta in the chaitanya. That is also questioned. Therefore, the ahankara artha or the prapancha artha or the dharma of the ahankara cannot be adhyasta, so there cannot be arthadhyasa, and jnana adhyasa is also refuted. Therefore, adhyasa of jnana not being possible, of artha or vishaya not being possible, they all should be considered as what? Prama and prameya also, respectively. So arthasya pramatvam should be understood arthasya satyatvam, or if you take the prameyatvam. Or if you take the other part there itself, you have pramatvam satyatvam cha. So it can be split as aham karomiti pratitehe pramatvam arthasya cha satyatvam. Why? Adhyasatva yoga. Both jnana adhyasa, pratiti adhyasa is not possible, and arthasya, vishesya adhyasa is not possible. Ahankari, ahankara, ahankaradi, dharmanam. Adhyasa na sambhavati. Therefore what? Satyatvam. Thereby what will happen? Aham narah iti samanadi karanyasya gaunatvam iti matam asteyam. Then you will have to say what? The aham narah. I am a human being. There manushyatva dharma is superimposed on oneself. But superimposition not possible. Therefore prama, it has to be taken as prama. If it is not prama, then what do you say? You have to say it is a gauna prayoga, gaunatvam. Samanadikaranam is there, but it is gauna. Iti matam asyam. It should be stated in some manner, you should explain it. Adhyasa is not possible. Then either you say it is a prama, it is so satya, or you say gauna. But some way you have to explain it, since adhyasa is not possible. This is the ratna prava. Tika. Pratitehe pramatvam yatharthanubhavatvam arthasya pramatvam tu abhaditattvam iti bheda. The visarga after iti is a typo there. Pramatvam ityasya uttarena iti shabdena anvayaha. So the gaunatvam iti, that pramatvam, so the anvaya is mentioned, but anyway, what is important to look at is pratitehe pramatvam and arthasya pramatvam. What is the pratitehe pramatvam? Yatharta anubhav, meaning it is prama. Pramatvam, pratitehe pramatvam, pratiti is prama, means it's satya. It is also satya. Yatharta anubhav, it is yatharta anubhav. It is not a brahma. So it is not a brahma, since it is not an adhyasa. What about arthasya pramatvam, vishayasya pramatvam? So arthasya pramatvam tu abharitattvam. So abharitattvam, meaning satyatvam, which cannot be negated. You cannot negate the vishaya as not being real. Therefore, what it is real? What is abharita vishaya? Sarpa in Rajju is a bhajita vishaya. Whereas this each and every artha, vyavaharika satta, which have vyavaharika satta, ghatapatadi prapancha or the Rajju there, on which there is a sarpa, brahma, their sarpa is badhita, but Rajju is not badhita. In Siddhanta, it is not badhita till Brahma Jnana takes place. After Brahmajnana, even the Ghatapatadi is Bhadita, there is a Bhadita Vritti. But in the Vyavahara Dasha itself, the Swapna, Swapna Anubhava, Swapna Prapancha, or the Rajju Sarpa Brahma, the Sarpa Brahma or the Rajata Brahma, it is a Brahma because those Vishaya, Rajata, Sarpa, these Vishayas become Bhadita by the Adhisthana Jnana. In the Vyavahara itself, therefore they are Bhadita, but this Artha will be Abhadita. Ahankaradi prapancha will be abadita, meaning satya. So satyattvam iti bhedaha pramatvam ityasya uttarana iti shabdena anvyaso iti pramatvam will connect with iti shabda iti pramatvam vaktavyam. So vaktavyam should be understood there. As a purvapakshya akshepa, it is so. But then we have to explain something, gaunatvam, etc. ननु अध्यास अनंगीकारे एक विभक्तित्व विरुद्धत्वे सति एकार्थ बोधकत्व रूपस्य अहम् नरः इति पदयोः समानादिकरणस्य प्रयोग कथम् इत्याशंक्य नीलो घट इत्यत्र नील गुणाश्रय घटः इतिवत् नरत्व विशिष्ट देह संबंध्यहम् इति आत्मीयत्व रूप गुणयोगात् गौणहयम् गौणोयम् समानादिकरण प्रयोग इति पूर्वपक्षितात्पर्यम् आह अहम् नर इति. So Purvapakshi has this intention to saying that first he has said that pratiti aham karomi, that pratiti is prama, and artha vishaya also, all the vishayas are ahankaradi, vishayas are arthas are satya, being abadita. Now since adhyasa is not accepted, danu adhyasa anangikare, because of what? Samagri abhavat, samagri अभावात अध्यासत्व अयोगात, therefore अध्यास is not accepted, and therefore what? अध्यास अनंगीकारे एक विभक्ति विरुद्धत्वे सति एकार्थ बोधकत्व रूपस्य अहम्, एक विभक्ति अविरुद्धत्वे, एक विभक्ति अविरुद्धत्वे is एक विभक्ति अविरुद्धत्वे. So one विभक्ति is being used there. अहम नरह, अहम इज प्रथमा एक वचन, नरह इज ऑल्सो प्रथमा एक वचन, देर बाय देर इज नो विरोध, विभक्ति विरोध इज नॉट देर, विभक्ति इज सेम, अविरुद्ध इज देर, अविरोध इज देर, देर फोर एकार्थ बोधकत्व रूपस्य अहम नरह इति पदयोः, व्हाट डू दे रिवील, दे रिवील एकार्थ, दी पदार्थ इज वन, एकार्थ इज एक पदार्थ, दी एंटिटी रिवील्ड बाय अहम एज वेल एज नरह बिकॉज बोथ आर इन प्रथमा एक वचन, लाइक दी नील घट, सो वेन यू से नील घट यू से इट इज अ नील, इट इज दैट एंटिटी विच इज नील एंड इट इज दैट एंटिटी विच इज घट, समानाधिकरण इज देर. सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो अहम नरह इति पदयोः समानादिकरणस्य प्रयोगः कथम, हाउ कैन इट बी, व्हाय, बिकॉज अध्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल, अहंकार इज डिफरेंट यू आर सेइंग एंड आत्मा इज डिफरेंट, अनात्मा एंड आत्मा आर डिफरेंट, हाउ कैन देर बी एक विभक्ति प्रयोगा देर समानादिकरण्य प्रयोग अहम नरह, बिकॉज अहम इज रियली आत्मा. Because you are saying, by reflexive sense, you are saying, I am, what? Then you say, Naraha. That Naraha is body. The body does not claim aham. You claim aham, whoever that entity is. That Chaitanya, who manifests as aham, that is equated with Naraha. Naratvam is there in the, Naratvam is Manushyatvam. Manushyatvam is in the Deha. Neither the antakarana nor the atma. So deha aham, this is the idea, deha is anatma, aham is actually atma. How can there be, without adhyasa, how can there be such a prayoga of samanadikaranyam? Iti ashanke nilo ghataha ityatra nila gunashraya ghataha. Then the solution would be what? In the nila ghataha, nila is color, it's a dark color. Let's take blue color. So the blue color and the ghata are not one. They are different. But what do you explain it as when there is a samana vikarnam? Neela guna ashraya ghata. The neela guna, the red color, the blue color is there in the ghata. So it's an ashraya in which this blue color rests. This is how Tarkika will explain. So neelatva, neelatva guna ashraya ghata. Neelatva vishishta ghata. Thereby, here also if you extend, iti vatu, naratva vishishta deha sambandha. So the deha has naratva guna. Manushyatva guna is there in deha. So naratva vishishta deha sambandhi aham. Here, I have some sambandha. Just like there is an ashraya, ashrita bhava in the neela ghata example, in the exemplified, here there is a naratva vishishta deha, which I am not. Why? And adhyasa is not possible. So, sambandha is there, some sambandha has to be mentioned. I am connected in some way to this deha, therefore, naratva vishishta deha sambandhi aham. I have sambandha, tadatme sambandha. But, tadatme sambandha has been refuted, it is not adhyasa. So this sambandha has to be what? It is real. Or what? You say, there is some guna sambandha, therefore, atmiyatva rupa guna yogad gaudoyam samanarikarnya prayoga iti purvapakshitatparyam aha. Then what should you say? It is a gauna prayoga. Meaning you know that it is not you, but they still you end up saying that. Like in upasana also. You know that the Shivalinga is a linga shaped, it's a stone. You know that it is a stone, but then there is a prana pratishtha done where you invoke the Lord in the form of Shiva. So Shivalinga is not Shiva, but it is Shiva as well. You know the Bheda, that when you clean the Shivalinga, that time you know that you are cleaning the stone, you will treat it as a stone and clean it. Whatever needs to be done, unlike, you know, real Shiva cannot be treated in that manner. Real living entity, for example, you take your own self. The way you clean yourself and the way you clean the Shivalinga is different. You won't use a brush on yourself the way you will use a brush on stone if there is oil. Or ghee has been poured, honey has been poured, then you have to clean it with water and you may have to scrub also, which you won't do it to Shiva obviously. So you know this difference. However, during puja, you have a different bhava there. So you invoke that kind of a bhavana and then you do the puja where you see Shiva as in the Shivalinga itself. That is Gauna Prayoga, where you know the difference, but then the adhyasa is still done. Purposely done for the sake of upasana, for the sake of puja. Here in this case also let it be so, as to you know the difference, but then you are superimposing by sambandha. What is that sambandha? Atmiyatva rupa guna. That is the sambandha. Aham iti atmiyatva rupa guna yogat gaunoyam samanarikaranya prayoga iti purvapakshi tatparimaha. So either you say it is real or you explain some gauna prayoga by sambandha. Why? Because adhyasa otherwise is not possible. You have already said so. So you have already said so. It's an expression given by the Purvapakshi himself. And then he is saying this is the conclusion. Narapadam naratva vishishta deha param naratvam avayava samsthana rupa dharma vishesha. So what is this narapada used there? Aham naraha. Nara is naratva vishishta deha. So what it means, it stands for is Naraha, when you say, then it stands for the body which is Naratva Vishishta. Not Pakshitva Vishishta, not Kitatva Vishishta, they are also Deha, but Naratva Achinna Deha. This Deha which is known by Naratvam. So Manushyatvam is there. And what is this Narattvam also? Narattva Vishishta Deha, what is Narattvam? Narattva is a particular configuration of the body. So there is a Avayava Samsthana Rupa Dharma Vishesha. only when a body is configured in a particular manner, you will call it as a manushya sharira. When it is configured differently, it will be called as the content of the body may be same, but then they are put together differently. That is the idea. With a pakshi kind of a configuration, it will pakshitva will be there, and then you will see that they are differently. Anyway, it is all understood, nothing difficult there. Thereby what? Brahmatmatva mate. In the Advaita mata, where Brahma is Atma, there pramatvam gaunatvam cha avashyam vaktavyam iti matam asteyam sthitam iti bhavaha. So you have to talk about it as satya. Here and has been mentioned, it can be read as and also or also. Gaunatvam should be talked about. So both should be mentioned here. Because there is an anubhava. Aham nara is an anubhava, which cannot be denied. Iti matam asthyam. Iti matam asthyam sthitam iti bhava. So this is what we have landed on in and through the discussion that we have had. Vyavahita vrittanuvada purvakam paramatam upasamharati. Now, whatever has been discussed in closing, he gives the anuvada purvakam paramata. What is the purvapakshi mata? Tathacha. Then, tathacha in the Ratna Prabha, tathacha bandhasya satyataya. So, what is the purvapakshi's conclusion now? He has concluded that you have to talk about gaunatvam satyatvam. Satyatvam has to be talked about. Once you talk about satyatvam, since adhyasa is not possible, it is satya. What is satya? Aham nara. This pratiti, aham karomi, is satya. Vishaya is satya. Prapancha is satya. And aham karomi pratiti is satya. Since aham karomi pratiti is satya, bandha is satya. Because karta has to be a bhokta, he will be enforced to be a bhokta. Otherwise, there will be avyavastha. I do something and I do not get the result, why would I do? I do it for the sake of the result, and Ishwara has promised me that he will give me result based on what I do. If I do papa, I'll get dukkha. If I do punya, I'll get sukha. Shastra, through Shastra, Ishwara has given me a promise. Now, I, the jiva, aham karomi, have this pratiti aham karomi. This is a satya pratiti now, since adhyasa is not possible. Therefore, my bandha to the karma phala is also real. My samsarana is real. Therefore what? Tathacha bandhasya satyataya. Since bandha is satya, will it go with jnana? It will not go by jnana at all. Bandhasya satyatvataya jnanat nivritti rupa phala sambhavat. Since the jnana cannot take away bandha. Jnanena nivritti hi bandhasya na sambhavati. And that is your phala. What is your phala? Nivritti rupa phala. Bandha nivritti is your phala, moksha. And that bandha nivritti jnanat na sambhavati, kuta na sambhavati, bandhasya satyataya. Because bandha is satya. Jnana can take away only which is wrongly understood. Jnana can take away sarpa which is seen in the case of Rajju, instead of the Rajju. If you are seeing sarpa as sarpa, sarpa is real. So sarpa being real, the fear of the sarpa being real, the poison of the sarpa being real, Jnana saying that it is a rope will not take away visha, it will not take away your fear, and it will not take away sarpa also. So Jnana will not give you mukti if the bandha is satya. Therefore what? Baddha mukta yor jiva brahmano. Baddha mukta yor jiva brahmanor aikya yogena. Vishaya sambhavat. Vishaya is not possible. What is your vishaya? Your phala is jnanena nivritti. Jnanena bandhasya nivritti. Bandha nivritti is your phala. That phala is not possible because jnana cannot take it away because bandha is satya. Now this baddha jiva and mukta brahma cannot have aikya. Baddha mukta yor jiva brahmanor aikya yogena. Since aikya is not possible because jnana is what? this jnana that you are talking about is Advaita jnana, Brahma and Jiva Aikya. Jiva is Baddha, Satyatvena Baddha, Satyataya Baddha, whereas Brahma is Mukta. Anyway, Shruti reveals Brahma and reveals as Mukta. This Mukta Brahma and Satya Baddha Jiva, Satya Mukta Brahma and Satya Baddha Jiva cannot have Aikya. How can they have Aikya? One is a samsari, other is a samsari. Jnana is not going to change that fact. Therefore, what Vishaya is not possible. If the Vishaya is not possible, what will happen if the Vishaya is not possible? You cannot have this Grantha itself. This Grantha is meaningless. Thereby, he says that since it is so, this Grantha is meaningless and therefore, na arambaniyam shastram. Shastram na arambhaniyam iti puro paksha bhashya tatparyam. So far what we have seen is the tatparya. Now the tatparya of that is what? Puro pakshi says that there is no vishaya at all for you to have such a grantha shastra, and therefore shastram na arambhaniyam, you need not bring about this Brahma Sutra or Adhyasa Bhashya also. Now, what has been said there, this Purvapakshi Akshepa is concluded in the Bhashya, Adhyasa Bhashya, Vishaye Adhyaso Mithyayati Bhavitum Yuktam. Ends with Mithyayati Bhavitum Yuktam. So, Vishaye, Vishayinaha Adhyasa, Vishay is the conclusion there. So, what has been said? Yushmat Asmat Pratyay Gocharayoho. Yushmat Pratyay Gochara cannot have adhyasa, cannot be adhyasta in asmat pratyay gochara atma. So yushmat pratyay gochara anatma and their dharmas cannot be adhyasta in asmat pratyay gochara atma, chaitanya, chidatmaka and tadviparyena. In the yushmat pratyay gochare, in the anatma, there cannot be atma, asmat pratyay gochara atma, who is a vishayi and its dharma superimposed. So, vishayasya vishayini adhyasa na sambhavati. And vishayasya vishayini adhyasa na sambhavati and vishaye vishayinaha adhyasa na sambhavati and taddharmanam. Now, that being so, what? Adhyasa is what? Mithya iti bhavitum yuktam. Adhyasa meaning dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa, both ways. Atma dharma and atma on anatma and anatma dharma and anatma on atma. Dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa, both are what? Mithya bhavati has not been said. Mithya iti bhavati has not been said, mithya iti bhavitum yuktam has been mentioned. So it is logical that it should be mithya. Not being said, it is mithya. So what does that show? So the Ratna Prabhakara says yukta grahana, since yuktam has been mentioned, bhavitum yuktam, natu bhavati. Bhavitum yuktam means it shouldn't be so, adhyasa shouldn't be there, but it is there. That's what it means. So it shouldn't be so. When you say it shouldn't be so, it is there. But it shouldn't be so. How can it be? So these are all questions which say it is so. Because there is a basis to say it is so. Thereby there is a weakness shown in this akshepa. Yukta grahana purvapaksha se durbalattvam suchayati. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara quotes the purvapakshi and says that this is a weak argument. Why? Because it is anubhava siddha. That is why mithya bhavitum yuktam, mithya iti bhavitum yuktam, not mithya. Adhyasa is not mithya, adhyasa should be mithya, meaning adhyasa shouldn't be possible. Mithya means what? False. It nasti ityartha. So mithya means nasti and therefore adhyasa nasti, but not nasti, nasti iti bhavitum yuktam. That adhyasa isn't there, That should be logical conclusion. But what happens? There is adhyasa anubhava siddha. How can you refute that? Therefore, durbalatvam sucheti. Tika, na arambhaniyam iti, na vicharaniyam ityartha. So you need not do any vichara in this. It has no conclusion because bandhai satya, it will not go by vichara rupa jnana. Vichara janya jnana. Pujitopi vedanta vichara na kartavyeti bha. So mimamsa that you are doing is invalidated. It is fruitless, purposeless. Vastuta pratitito vyavaharata sabdatascha iti chaturvida prayuktad grahya grahakatva prayuktatvacha paraspara aikya yogad paraspara aikya aikyadi paraspara aikyadi ayogat ayogatva rupa virodhat tamah prakashavad atmanatmanor dharminor vastavat tadatmyadyabhave na dharma samsarga bhavah iti tat pramaya sambhavena tajjanya samskarasya adhyasa hetoho asambhavat atadrupe tadrupa avabhasa rupa adhyasaha nasti. So the virodha which has been shown as tamah prakashavad virodha. Swabhavata, vastutaha there is a virodha between atma and anatma, swabhava. Pratitita virodha is there. Yutpatti wise also, one is a karma, the other is bhavi yutpatti. So pratiyate iti pratyaya and then pratiti pratyaya. There is virodha there. Vastutaha virodha is yushmat and asmat. There is a vastuta swabhavata virodha. You cannot be me, I cannot be you. Idam cannot be I cannot be idam. Vyavaharataha. Vyavaharataha also aham karomi and then aham brahma. There is a difference. One is karta, the other is akarta. So karta bhokta and akarta bhokta cannot be one. Vyavaharata virodha is there. Shabdatascha. Shabda also is different. You don't use the word yushmat for asmat and asmat for yushmat. Shabdataha cha. So four types of virodhas have been shown. Chaturvida prayuktad grahya grahakatva prayuktatva cha. And then further what? One is grahya, the other is grahaka. Atma is grahaka and then anatma is grahya. Subject object also there is a virodha. Therefore what? Paraspara aikyadi ayogatva rupa virodhat. Aikya and adipada tadatmya also. There is a aikya is not possible. Tadatmya sambandha is also not possible. There is a virodha. How? Tamah prakashavad. Like light and darkness cannot be one. There cannot be tadatmya sambandha also. Bheda sahita abheda is also not possible. Therefore what? Atmanatmano dharminoho vastava tadatma adyabhave na dharma samsarga abhava. Since dharmi aikya is not possible, dharmi samsarga dharmi tadatmya sambandha is not possible, therefore dharma samsarga is also not possible. Dharma samsarga is possible, dharma adhyasa is possible only when dharmi adhyasa is there. Thereby dharma samsarga abhava, dharma adhyasa is also not possible. Iti tat pramaya sambhavena. Tat pramaya sambhavena tajjanya samskarasya adhyasa heto asambhavat. Since prama is not possible of aikya or tadatmya between dharmis or dharmas, therefore tajjanya samskara bhava is there. There is no samskara possible. Since samskara is not there, adhyasa is not possible. Adhyasa hetu ho asambhavat. Adhyasa hetu samskara is not there. Therefore adhyasa is not going to be possible because there was never an aikya or tadatmya prama. And thereby such pramajanya samskara wasn't there. And samskara janya tadatmya adhyasa or aikya adhyasa is not possible. Brahma is not possible. And what is this adhyasa? Atadrupe tadrupa avabhasa rupa adhyasa. The adhyasa is tadrupa in atadrupa. In that which is not atma having atma adhyasa or that which is not anatma having atma spurana or atma pratiti, that is adhyasa. That kind of adhyasa nasti. Mithya. Mithya means nasti. Tathacha bandhasya satyataya. Therefore bandha is satya. And being satya, the satyata is hetau tritiya. बिकॉज ऑफ बंध हैविंग सत्यता, बंध से सत्यतया ज्ञानात निवृत्ति रूप फलासंभवात, ज्ञान विल नॉट टेक अवे दैट बंध, सो यू कांट हैव सच फला ऑल्सो, बंध निवृत्ति फला इज नॉट पॉसिबल. बंध मुक्त यो जीव ब्रह्मणोर ऐक्या योगेन, एंड सिंस ज्ञान ऐक्य ज्ञान कैनॉट गिव दिस बंध मुक्ति, बंध बंध निवृत्ति रूप फला, योर विषय विच इज ऐक्य बिटवीन जीव एंड ब्रह्म, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल. दैट ज्ञान इज मिथ्या, दैट ज्ञान इज ऑल्सो मिथ्या, दिस इज वॉट द आक्षेप इज, इट इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ऐक्य अयोग्य इज देर, therefore vishaya bhavat, vishaya isn't there, therefore shastram na arambaniyam, and in conclusion series of logically thought about and led to a conclusion, simple conclusion, he says shastram na arambaniyam, there is no use for this shastra, iti adhyasa purvapaksha bhashya tatvaryam iti sudhibhir vibhavaniyam. This is what we should understand, sadhaka should understand, this is the akshepa of the पूर्वपक्षी. इति अध्यास पूर्वपक्ष ग्रंथ व्याख्या समाप्ता. सो इन द टीका ऑन द व्याख्या रत्नप्रभा, रत्नप्रभा ऑल्सो एंड्स देयर विद द अध्यास आक्षेप, अध्यास भाष्य पूर्वपक्ष, इट इज पूर्वपक्ष ग्रंथ व्याख्या विच इज एंडिंग हियर, एंड नाउ वी लुक एट द सिद्धांत इज रिस्पॉन्स, तथा ही विद तथा ही इन द रत्नप्रभा, एंड तथापि इज द भाष्य विच इज द रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ द सिद्धांति टू दिस पूर्वपक्ष, विच इज दैट मिथ्या इति भवितुम युक्तम, अध्यास मिथ्या इति भवितुम युक्तम. हाउ डज द सिद्धांति काउंटर दिस, दैट दिस अध्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल, एंड इफ यू एक्सेप्ट दैट अध्यास इज नॉट पॉसिबल, नॉट दैट अध्यास इज शुडंट बी पॉसिबल बट इट इज पॉसिबल, दैट इज वॉट इट मीन्स रियली. But if the Purvapakshi means that he has not said mithya bhavati, even if he says that Siddhanti has quoted his Purvapaksha as bhavitum yuktam, you can say it is a weak argument. It shouldn't be, but it is so. Then why is it so? We'll explain. How is it possible? We'll explain. But it is possible. That is the going to be the answer. We'll see that in the next part. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहं हरिं परमाश्रये, तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. यमिह कारुणिकं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहं आशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. जस्ट एनी क्वेश्चंस? आई विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.